Step 1. A simple movie. We begin by loading a configuration with different views. A scatter plot, parallel coordinates and a text searcher in addition to the overlapper. Mission Impossible 2 is selected. Rated above 5 by high amount of IMDb users. The MI2 profile in parallel coordinates shows that it is a popular and money-making film without academic awards. Navigating through scatter plots, we can do one-to-one comparisons. The overlapper represents a film as a kind of bubble, a person's being glyphs inside it. We can customize the representation to avoid cluttering. This feature is important when lots of films are represented. The main actor in MI2 is Tom Cruise. The director is John Woo. Tom Cruise produces the film along with Terence Chang. The user can change the visualization by dragging or fixing nodes, modifying forces, pausing simulation, showing labels, and so on. Overview plus detail is provided at the top right, allowing navigation. Details of each person are gathered on demand from imdb.com. Finally, the cast size of the displayed film can be controlled by a filter. Step 2. Single person. Focusing on a person allows you to analyze his or her films and relationships. Let's try with Catherine Zeta-Jones, a well-known actress. The top left scatter plot highlights her movies, very well rated by the public. The word cloud shows the keywords associated to her films. And the distribution companies with which she mainly works. The overlapper shows a floor-like shape, with Catherine in the center. The size of glyphs is proportional to the number of films related to each person. Golden glyphs are Oscar winners, a legend at the bottom right explains it. Another way to highlight relationships are pie charts. In pie charts, radial lines give the number of films related to the person. There are two people that have worked 3 times with Catherine within the analyzed period. Steven Spielberg and George Clooney. She also worked with Benicio del Toro, Oscar winner for Traffic. Step 3. Word clouds. Let's start again with Catherine Zeta-Jones. two of her films have the keyword femme fatale. Let's see which other films have also this keyword. 25 films, two of them very related, as seen at the top right in the overlapper. We can filter films that do not have a close relationship. Let's see who are our femme fatale. Along with Catherine, Lucy Liu, and Angelina Jolie. A tight group at the top is Kill Bill, volumes 1 and 2. Finally, to unclutter the view, we can hide Hoss. Step 4, the overlapper. The overlapper name comes from the tool's capability to superimpose different kinds of analysis. For example, we want to analyze which groups are important depending on popularity, highly voted, earnings, box office, and critics, awards. Three scatterplots help us in this task. The first one, red, will get the most popular films. The second one, green, will give us the films that earned more money. Some people will overlap, working in both popular and profitable movies. Pie charts help us see that. Finally, the third scatter, yellow, will provide the most award movies. Green, that is money groups, appear clearly. Films that give money tend to have sequels. Orlando Bloom is a money machine, involved in Pirates of the Caribbean and Lord of the Rings. Star Wars, Harry Potter, and Spider-Man are other examples of successful sagas. Popular and award films are less connected. Sometimes relating people, as it is the case of Ron Howard or Sean Penn. Ian Holm is a rare case of actor, working in both profitable and awarded movies. Is director Ang Lee in some of these movies? Let's look for him. Yes, he is. He directed Brokeback Mountain and was given an award for it. we can explode his node and see all his films. Connections with another important people would appear. Got it. In Hawk, he worked with the influential composer Danny Elfman.